So far, I've made videos on the history of kefir, as well as how to make it. I've touched on the things that I deem to be the most important when it comes to this great nutritional drink, such as the quality of ingredients, as well as why store-bought kefir is far from optimal. Now, in this video, I would like to talk about why exactly kefir is so great. Honestly, kefir has so many beneficial compounds and mechanisms that it's almost impossible to mention them all in one video. But I will try my best to make it as brief and digestible as possible. In this video, you will hear me mention terms such as vitamins, minerals, amino acids, and peptides. Some of these terms have been thrown around in mainstream circles so much that they have entirely lost their meaning. So first of all, let me establish why these are not just mere terms, but actually what makes us human and alive. In this context, it might be beneficial to first ask the question, why do we eat? Some people will probably say that we eat to get energy, and while that is not wrong, it misses the full picture. If we solely ate for energy purposes, sugar would be the only food source that we would need, and I don't think anyone would recommend a pure sugar diet. The truth is that we eat to acquire nutrients. It's really that simple. Vitamins, minerals, and amino acids are called essential for a reason, because our bodies simply can't make them themselves, and therefore need them from outside sources. Or in other words, we need to get them from the food we eat. This is fundamentally the problem with the standard Western diet today. So much food that we eat today is simply deprived of nutrients, and people are stuffing themselves with foods that have close to no nutrition. All they are eating is caloric energy. They are on a high calorie, low nutrient diet, so to speak. Another fundamental problem with the way that we view nutrition in mainstream circles today is that we completely neglect the term bioavailability. Bioavailability pretty much means the way that your body is able to absorb the nutrients of whatever you are eating. We see this in, for example, plant-based dieters, who often seem to think that the only thing which matters is what the nutritional information on the paper or on the smartphone app says. Now, I'm not saying this to hate on vegans or plant-based dieters in particular, but there seems to be a fundamental misunderstanding of which vitamins, minerals, and amino acids that are bioavailable to our human bodies. You simply can't create life off of what it says on the nutritional paper. You have to actually feel and see life in yourself by eating actual nutrient-dense foods which fills your needs. Now, why is this even important when it comes to kefir? Because that is exactly the fundamental thing that makes kefir such an amazing nutritional drink. The fermentation process in kefir not only makes you able to digest the drink itself better and absorb its nutrients efficiently, but the bacteria created colonizes your gut and makes you able to absorb everything else you eat much more efficiently. I can't even describe how valuable this mechanism is. The bioavailability aspect of kefir is probably the key concept that makes it so amazing, as it can take compounds unavailable to your body system and convert them into real nutrition readily available to your body. The grains themselves eat and digest it all for you, so all you have to do is simply drink your magical concoction of bioavailable nutrition. You could even think of the grains the same way as a cow eating grass. The cow eats the grass and converts it into bioavailable nutrition using its advanced four-stomach digestive system. Now, when you eat the cow, you get the nutrition of the grass in a way that is available to your human nature, because the cow has taken care of all the conversion for you. You gain nothing from eating the grass, but you gain everything from eating the cow. This is why animal foods tend to be more impactful when it comes to nutrition than plant foods. Because most plant foods needs to have their nutrition converted before being absorbed by the human body. And in almost all cases, this conversion process is far from optimal. Animal nutrition, on the other hand, has no need of conversion and is simply integrated and absorbed in the human body. I'm not saying this to hate on plant foods, because I do believe that they have a valuable role as a staple in people's diets, but when it comes to essential nutrients, they are simply not enough. Okay, this was enough ranting on nutrients and bioavailability, but my point is to make it clear that vitamins, minerals, amino acids, and all of these other technical terms are not just mere jargon. They are what expresses our genes. They are what makes our bones grow. They are what makes us attractive. They are what makes us able to reproduce among thousands of other mechanisms. This is very important to understand, in my opinion, if you want to have a better grasp on why kefir is as effective as it is, as well as just understanding nutrition in general. Because what we need is bioavailable nutrition that our body can use directly and which it doesn't have to convert. If you're just dousing your stomach with plants and supplements, thinking that it's going to turn into essential life-creating nutrition, I'm afraid you're fooling yourself. With that said, let's move on to the specifics of kefir and its amazing nutrition. Starting off with the most known and impactful component, the bacteria. If we simply take a look at the sheer amount of bacterial strains contained in real kefir, it's not hard to see why it's considered such a probiotic powerhouse. There is between 30 to 60 different bacterial strains in kefir, as far as we know. Contrast this to something like store-bought kefir or yogurt, which is also considered a strong probiotic by many people, but only has 5 to 10 different bacterial strains at absolute best. Already by looking at this small comparison, are we starting to see that real homemade kefir is indeed something unique. However, it is not only the abundance of bacterial strains that makes kefir such a probiotic powerhouse. It also just so happens to be the exact type of bacterial strains that most people need in today's modern world. Many people today have what is known as gut dysbiosis, which is essentially an imbalance in their gut microbiome. This imbalance in the gut creates way more problems for the average person than they realize. You may have heard the gut microbiome being described as the second brain of our body, and this really isn't a shambolic statement. Because the gut is responsible for much more of our overall health and well-being than we realize. The bacteria in the microbiome help digest and absorb the nutrients of our food, regulate our immune system, protect against other bacteria that cause disease, produces vitamins, among many other things. What is more interesting is that the gut also produces neurotransmitters, such as dopamine, GABA, and serotonin. Actually, the gut produces 95% of the body's serotonin. If you don't know what serotonin is, it's a neurotransmitter that impacts our entire body and stabilizes our mood, feelings of well-being, and happiness. GABA is another neurotransmitter, which produces a calming effect and helps with feelings of anxiety, stress, and fear. We could go more in depth, but so far it should be clear that the state of our gut microbiome is entirely crucial for how we live and feel on a daily basis. This is where kefir comes into the picture as the ultimate probiotic. Kefir directly takes hold of these imbalances that many people have in their gut, and it colonizes it with much needed bacterial strains of the right quality and quantity. It's simply impossible to get this from many other places in our modern world. This is also why pretty much all probiotic supplements are close to useless when compared to kefir. They simply don't have the right mixture and composition of bacterial strains. The probiotic supplement that you are taking might say something like over 600 million live bacteria in one pill, but this will have close to no effect on the state of your gut microbiome because it simply is the wrong bacterial strains and in the wrong ratios. With probiotics, you should feel an impact and effect pretty quickly in terms of mood and overall well-being. If you are not seeing this from your store-bought probiotic drinks and supplements, chances are they are not doing anything. However, if you try to drink some real high-quality kefir, I bet that you will see this effect pretty quickly. Let me remind you here that kefir still remains a mystery to science and that the kefir grains have no way of being recreated. So the bacterial strains that we are seeing here are thereby only what our human eyes and minds can grasp at this moment. And who knows, maybe there is more to it than we can see. Maybe that is why we are unable to create supplements that have the same effect as kefir, and maybe that is why we are unable to recreate kefir grains. Let me also remind you how bacteria is one of the fundamental principles for life to take place at all. Humans have more bacteria in their gut than they have cells in their entire body. And actually, bacteria is the most dominant organism on this whole planet. In our modern world, bacteria seems to have gotten a bad reputation, and it seems like we go out of our way to kill as many of these bacteria as possible, and with no regard of how beneficial many of them actually are. We seem completely obsessed about making our environment and ourselves as sterile as possible, whether this is through pasteurization and processing of our foods, prescribing antibiotics to everyone, even children, and of course our more recent and widespread fixation with sanitation and total eradication of all germs within our vicinity. Kefir offers us an opportunity to revive some of these natural and beneficial organisms, which we are currently killing like never before. Humans and bacteria have co-evolved. Actually, bacteria was here first, and right now we might be killing many of our greatest companions, and with it, we are compromising our own health and happiness. Kefir offers us a way back in touch with our natural needs, and that is exactly why it's so effective and valuable. If we take a look at studies and observations of indigenous groups, we will see that there is one common denominator when it comes to their diets. All indigenous groups consumed some type of fermented food on a regular basis, and this was more than likely a big part of what kept them healthy and disease-free. Since most people today don't want to eat rotten meat, like some of these indigenous groups did, and since most dairy today is nuked off of pretty much all bacteria and nutrients, it seems that kefir is one of the last standing options when it comes to getting these beneficial bacteria that real fermentation provides. Now, I could go more in depth with all of these bacterial strains and what makes them so necessary in our standard Western diets. We could also go in depth on how our trigger happiness when it comes to the administration of antibiotics might literally be causing mental illness in ourselves and our children. But all of this would be a very long and complicated topic, so maybe that is best saved for another more in-depth video. For now, let's keep it somewhat short and simple and move on to the other nutritional components of kefir. Kefir contains a wide range of digestive enzymes. Digestive enzymes help break down the fat, protein, and carbohydrates of the things we eat. A helpful way to think about the digestive enzymes in kefir is that everything in the milk is literally pre-digested for you, giving you all the fats, proteins, and carbohydrates in an easily absorbable way for your body. The most commonly known digestive enzyme in kefir is probably the lactase enzyme, which breaks down the lactose of the milk. This enzyme usually breaks down up to 99% of the lactose in kefir over a 24-hour fermentation period. This is why many people with lactose intolerances are able to tolerate milk kefir. The digestive enzyme properties of milk kefir really is something noteworthy. High-quality milk is already something very healthy and something which is easily absorbed by our bodies. And once you make kefir out of it, this absorption process becomes even more efficient. Another very noteworthy mechanism is how kefir breaks down protein. All the protein you eat gets broken down into individual amino acids in your body. Our bodies need specific amino acids, and in total there are 9 amino acids which are essential to our body. Essential in this case means that our body can't make them, and we therefore need them from outside sources. To just put it shortly, amino acids are very important building blocks for our body. High quality milk already contains all of these 9 essential amino acids. And when you make kefir out of this milk, you're making these amino acids even more available to your body due to the way the fermentation process pre-digests the protein. It is possible to go more in depth with all of these specific amino acids. For example, the one called tryptophan, which among other things helps your body to produce melatonin, something which is very important in regulating sleep. Again though, it would be very long and complicated to go in depth with all of these different amino acids. So for now, let's move on to another interesting quality of kefir, its many peptides. Now peptides are essentially shorter chains of amino acids. There exist several hundreds of different peptides, and each has a different role in your body. Peptides are very important and play a big role in, for example, muscle growth and skin health. You may have heard of the peptides creatine and collagen, which help boost muscle growth, muscle repair, and skin health. Now in kefir, there have been detected over 200 unique peptides, which is much more impressive than it may sound. These specific peptides were not present in the milk itself before fermentation, but once it had undergone fermentation with kefir grains, all of these peptides were present in the kefir. Now you can imagine how long it would take to go in depth with all of these many peptides. But to give an overview, these are some of the qualities that the unique peptides in kefir provides us with. Many of the peptides are antimicrobial and help us kill harmful bacteria, yeasts, fungi, viruses, and even cancer cells. The peptides found in kefir are also high in antioxidants, which removes free radicals in your body. The peptides are antithrombotic, which means they can help with things such as blood clotting. These peptides also help modulate our immune system and our immune response. We could go on and on in this fashion, but I hope that you see the big picture of how important peptides are for our overall health. The abundance of peptides uniquely found in kefir is nothing short of amazing. So just to sum up a bit here, kefir is extremely valuable due to its pre-digested content, which helps your body maximize the absorption of important amino acids and peptides. This has both immediate, short-term, and long-term benefits, because all of these things are being produced by the probiotic content of the kefir. So as you are consuming kefir on a regular basis, you are essentially repopulating your gut so that your gut microbiome is able to produce these enzymes, peptides, etc. much more efficiently. Lastly, I just want to briefly touch on the vitamins and minerals found in kefir. Milk kefir is close to what we know as a complete food source, and you will get a lot of vitamins from it. Most noteworthy is the fact that you get the full complement of B vitamins, which are water-soluble vitamins, and therefore you need them on a regular basis because they leave the body very quickly. Some B vitamins are also needed in very large doses, and kefir is an excellent source of this. Kefir is better than any vitamin B complex supplement that you will ever take. Kefir can also have good amounts of vitamin C, especially if you do a second fermentation with fruit. Furthermore, you will get the longer lasting and very important fat soluble vitamins A, D, and K2. Vitamin K2 is the one to look out for here, in my opinion, because it's very hard to get from other sources in today's sterile and pasteurized world. You need vitamin K2 to counterbalance your levels of vitamin A and D, and kefir offers an excellent opportunity for this. What's more important to understand, though, is that when you are getting these vitamins from kefir, you are getting the natural isomers, meaning it's bioavailable to your body. Contrast this to the supplements you are taking, or the fortified foods that you are eating, which have very unnatural isomers in them. This is because when we try to recreate the vitamins that occur in real food, we are not able to recreate it perfectly, and we end up missing a lot of important isomers that make the vitamin complete. Basically, we are often very flawed in the way we view these things, and it does indeed seem that nature sometimes knows best. You always want the natural source of vitamins. It's always the most effective. Lastly, kefir has a lot of different minerals. On the screen here, you can see some of the most noteworthy ones. Furthermore, kefir has a lot of trace minerals, which is not listed here. Phosphorus, iodine, and magnesium are particularly important for many people today, in my opinion. Now, this was pretty much all I wanted to touch on in this video. But make no mistake, there is tons of other stuff to be said when it comes to the benefits of kefir. It may sound like I'm highly biased when it comes to the nutrition of this magical drink, but it really is a powerhouse, and there's no way around that. As with most other things, it does have its downsides if it's abused. It is, for example, possible to create bacterial imbalances if you go crazy with kefir. It's also important not to go overboard on kefir if you are on a keto or very low carb diet. This is because the bacteria from kefir often needs carbohydrates to feed on in the gut. And therefore, I suggest a moderate intake of carbohydrates to experience the full benefits of kefir. It's also worth noting that all the benefits I've talked about in this video is only relevant when it comes to real kefir made from kefir grains. Meanwhile, it is worth understanding that everyone's kefir is different and will vary in many of these things depending on the environment, the quality of ingredients, and so forth. With all that said, I highly recommend you give real kefir a chance. Worst case, you think it tastes disgusting, and best case, it can change your life for the better. Lastly, just a word of caution. If you decide to consume kefir without any prior use of the drink or other healthy probiotics, it might start certain unsettling processes in the gut. This is perfectly normal and actually a good thing. You might notice that you will have a sort of, shall we say, chaotic bowel movement upon introduction of the drink. This is essentially you getting rid of your old gut microbiome and replacing it with the bacteria of kefir. If you want to avoid this as much as possible, start off very light with a couple of sips of kefir and work your way up. Enjoy your kefir, guys, and stay healthy.